Pranav, and I founded Trellis, a cannabis inventory management system. We work with a lot of cool companies. Join me to get an inside look into the rapidly growing cannabis industry. This is Trellis Travels. This week I'm at Eve Farms, a medical cannabis cultivation facility based in San Francisco, California. Their parent company, Australian Naturals Therapeutics Group, is based out of Australia and they research premium cannabinoid medicines for patients. I spoke with some of the team from Eve Farms about their cultivation techniques and how they've integrated Trellis into their workflow.
Eve Farms is a fully licensed medical marijuana cultivation facility. We have a heavy emphasis on research and development, researching and developing strains. We're doing a lot with breeding and trying to figure out how to unlock the full potential of our strains and our genetics in general. So the overview company is Australian Natural, based out of Australia. Being in Australia, the licensing was held up a little bit. It's a little bit more strict than it is here in the States. So they're looking to go anywhere they could to possibly grow. Them knowing that the Bay Area is kind of like the center of the universe for cannabis genetics, and they figured it'd be perfect place to start the breeding program. So our goal will be to research and develop as many strains as we can over here through our breeding program, get as much data as possible, and that way once licensing opens up in other states, other countries, other continents, we'd be part of the forefront.
So you're using Trellis here obviously to track the plants, and
yeah.
I guess tell me a little bit about that experience and what it was like before and how it is now.
Yeah, so before everything was written on plastic tags that you just stick in the plant and it could fall out anywhere along the way. Being that it's all the same plant, even though they're different varieties, they're the same plant, so it could be easy to mix up. So we used to have a big problem with mislabeling. Trellis has helped us kind of avoid that problem, as well as provide some ingenuity for our breeding program. So being with our breeding program, we'll, let's say, maybe plant 100 different seeds. All those are a different, unique strain to itself, and if you get one mixed up, you may never, ever get it unmixed up. What Trellis has helped us do is to pinpoint every strain and make sure that it stays clear all the way through from seed to sale.
My name's Jan. I'm taking care of the compliance here on the lower level. That is to say that I don't do harvest or cure, but keeping track of the plants, which you see here, both immature and then maturing into the flower phase, making sure that everything gets its own little unique identifier and stays in our track and trace system. I spend most of my time here in the veg room, and so since we do propagation here, a lot of my job is to keep track of the plants as they come into existence.
Yeah.
So making sure they get tagged as clones and come through this whole process, changing over to moms, basically managing the transfers.
How has your life changed kind of pre and post Trellis?
Oh man, the traceability that Trellis introduces to the system is really profound. Yeah, the amount of data that we create just incidentally by going through that compliance process is really quite amazing, and it all just kind of comes together in this dashboard here.
Nice.
You know, so it's also really improved communication with our upper management because they're in a different country, they're in Australia, and so the fact that it's transparent to them has really helped the communication within our company.
Tell us a couple things that you do more regularly in the software.
Well, a lot of it is the creation an organization of inventory. So as plants come into being, we have to trace where they were cut from, and what happened to them, when they die as well, and so we have like a steady count of our mortality rate and the reasons for that.
Yeah.
So a lot of my job is logging things, and including the transition into the flowering phase, so the stage of maturity of plants as well, I have to keep track of.
And are you doing this for fun, or is this...
Oh. Well, as you guys know, Trellis is integrating with Metric, so the basic motivation here is that all that transparency gets to the state of California. And they can see that everything is totally above board, which has been a wonderful thing to have with Trellis. It actually creates more transparency for us in terms of regulation. I think a lot of cannabis producers right now are rather confused by the quickly evolving state of those regs, and having one single sort of like desktop layout here with the sort of implication that everything we do on Trellis is required really gives us a framework to work with.
Obviously you see the benefit from the compliance side, but does it kind of go beyond that for the operational side? Is there any benefits from there?
Oh my goodness, I mean traceability of plant mortality and disease, knowing why something has gone wrong, when it goes wrong, is a huge part of this business. You know, and those things happen in transition, mostly,
yeah.
You know, especially because we're large enough to have different departments, so something comes from veg into flower, and a quarter of it shocks, and often no one knows why, but
yeah.
This creates the link.
Nice. You mentioned like the benefits of cloud, and what does that do for you guys?
Oh, well, the fact that anything that anybody does is totally accessible to everybody else. Your name is on everything that you do. So if I transfer plants, I have to put my code and it says it was Jan. If there's a problem with this or it doesn't make sense, ask Jan. Mm-hmm. You know, having that is really important, particularly considering in the hectic environment that we have here, it's pretty easy to forget what you've done a week later, you know? But this is really important for record keeping. So anybody can access it at any time. You can use any tablet, you just pick it up and go. And then as an international company, absolutely priceless. We have people in different time zones. They want all kinds of data all the time. Mm-hmm. This is the one way to get it to them without having to compile it ourselves.
I love what I do and I don't feel like I'm working. I get to work with an amazing plant that does amazing things for people, and I get to be on the forefront of it.
That's awesome.
So when we picked this building, it was a retrofit. It was already a cannabis cultivation facility at the moment. Being in San Francisco, rent is at a premium. So coming with Australian Natural, we looked into ways to maximize the production out of the facility. Before, where we used to grow all in one tier, one level, we've implemented vertical farming, which is growing upwards rather than laterally. So going through that process, we've gone up about 70% in overall canopy space and only 5% in power.
Nice. And is effect mostly in like the flowering area? Like we see racks here too, but is vertical farming also applicable for like propagation and vegging? Like, I guess it just gives you more space, right?
Yeah, well, vegging is easier because the lights we use don't put off as much heat.
Yeah.
The old lighting we used to use in the flower rooms were HID lighting, high intensity discharge, so they put off an enormous amount of heat. So we looked into LED technology. Doing that, we've been able to increase our light count in the room and go down in heat. Mm. So before, the rooms used to run about 130 lights and only 1,600 square feet canopy space. And now we're at 180 lights and 2,700 square feet.
Well, thanks, Jimmy. Thanks for having us by. Love the operations. It's growing significantly and glad to be part of it.
You're welcome. Anytime.
All right. See you around.
Thanks for tuning in. For more behind-the-scenes footage, check out trellisgrows.com. I'm Pranav, and I'll see you next time.